Okay, you guys, it's the Foxer JA47 coming back at you guys with another video, you guys. So I hope that you enjoy this video. Share this video with all of your friends everywhere. And most of all, show old school some love. So I'm here to talk about a story time, one part of my life. So as you know, guys, I got married at age 16 and the relationship never did exactly go right because this man that I married, this African man from Nigeria that only got married to me for his citizenship into the United States, he did not love me from the beginning. So how soon did I find that out after we got married? And I noticed like right away he wasn't showing any kind of love and affection or anything. So I'm saying to myself, this man can't love me. What in the world could have happened? This man just doesn't love me. He has never shown me really that he was in love with me. By me being young, of course, he said his things like, I want to marry you and all of these things like that. And you're the best lady that I've ever met. You know, yada, 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 things that men normally say to women. So, again, me being 16 and, you know, just beginning my life at 16, of course, I pretty much believe what he said. Again, like I said, after we got married, I started seeing a change, like quickly, a change of not wanting to spend time with me, not communicating with me, or none of that. So eventually, this is a part of my life. Eventually, he was going to school, he was in college, and he was working also, and I had just finished high school. So he said that he had to take exams and everything, and that he needed some time to himself. So remind you that we did not have kids, so I'm thinking to myself, what kind of time do you need to yourself? It's just me and you. I'm not in your way. I'm not bothering you. So that's what I'm thinking to myself. So I have an older sister where he asked her, could I come over to her house and stay until after he finished his exams in school? So she was like, okay, yeah, she can come over and stay until you finish your exam. So he told me, he said, well, I'm just going to take you over here for a few days until I finish my exams, and then I'm going to come back and pick you up. So I was crying and everything, upset, didn't know why he was taking me over there, didn't understand, why are you taking me over here till you finish exams? I'm not in your way, I'm not bothering you. This just doesn't seem right for me to have to go over to my sister's house and for you to take some exams. So anyway, my sister said yes, so he took me over to my sister's house, and when I got over to her house, you know, I was pretty upset about it. So I don't know, you guys, you know, like when you're pregnant, sometimes you get sick when you are pregnant, you vomiting and throwing up or whatever. I don't want to sound vulgar, but you're doing all of those things, and you know, morning sickness, not feeling good. So by him dropping me off over there, I began to get really, really depressed, and I began to get morning sickness, vomiting and everything. So I called him right away and I told him that I was sick and that I had went to the doctor. And he was like nonchalant, like, okay, so what do you want me to do? So remind you, this is my husband that dropped me off at my sister's house, so I'm not expecting you to be saying, what do you want me to do? This is not a stranger, this is not a boyfriend. So me being young, you know, I said, well, I don't know, I'm just telling you because it's your baby. That's why I'm telling you. So he was like,
how did you get pregnant? What happened? I don't understand how you get pregnant.
So, you know, I'm crying and doing, and I'm saying, what do you mean? You don't understand how I got pregnant. What do you mean? You know, so how did you let this happen? You know, I have my education to finish, my school and everything to finish. So why would you get pregnant? So, you know, like I said, I'm crying and I'm yelling and screaming. What do you mean? Why would I get pregnant? This is not me alone by myself. What do you mean? Why did I get pregnant? So we yelled back and forth at each other, you know, and I thought that when I told him that, I thought that, you know, he would come back and get me, but he was all about his education. He wasn't concerned about me. So I was at my sister's house, and I was really, really sick for like months. I was sick. He did not come over there to check on me. So remind you, he told me he was going to take his exams. He was coming back to get me, and he never did come back and get me. So I was sick and vomiting and everything, but he never came back to get me at all. So I got like 2 months pregnant, never heard anything back from him. 3 months pregnant, still didn't hear anything back from him. I was calling him on the telephone. I was calling him on the telephone and everything, and he still did not answer that telephone. So by that time, I did not know what I was gonna do. I didn't know who I was gonna talk to. I just didn't know. So my sister needed some help at her house. She needed a plumber because I think her toilet was backed up or something. So she called for a plumber to come to her house, and we started dating, and I was still upset and everything because I hadn't heard from my husband, so I just didn't know what I was gonna do. So me and this guy started dating, and I told him that I was married, and I told him what had actually happened between me and my husband, and he was like, don't worry about that. I'm here for you now. If you need anything, let me know. And then also I told him that I was pregnant, and I said, I'm 3 months pregnant, and he said, don't worry about it. Don't even worry about your husband not doing what he's supposed to do for you. Again, if you need anything, I'm here for you. I'll do anything that you need me to do to console you and comfort you. And so we started talking and started dating and everything. So 1 month went to another month, another month, another month. By then, I still hadn't heard from my husband yet. So I think I got about 9 months pregnant. I was still dating this guy, and he was still willing to date me and willing to be there for me and everything. And I think when I got 9 months pregnant, then my husband, he called when I got 9 months pregnant and said, is it anything that you need, any money or anything that you need, you know, to help you out? And I'm like, wow, like really? You was nowhere to be found the whole time I was pregnant. I suffered through this all alone with myself and this guy, you know, trying to console me and trying to talk to me. Now you're going to ask me at 9 months, do I need anything? So I was like, yeah, I need something, because in my mind, I'm like, you know what, we gonna get a divorce. I'm gonna let you go your way, and I'm gonna go my way, because what you did was messed up. You know, I'm thinking this to myself. So I'm like, he's saying, do you need anything? I'm saying, yeah. Go ahead and take what it is that he got to give you. So that's what I did. He said, do you need anything? So he started sending me like $150. He started sending me every week. And so I started taking that $150, putting it up. And I was still talking to the other guy. So when I went into labor, the other guy was still right there with me. My husband was nowhere to be found. The guy went with me to the emergency room. He went with me through labor. During that time when you have a baby, the day before you get ready to go home, they give you wine and steak dinner. I don't think they do that anymore, but they give you wine and steak dinner. And he was even there for the wine and steak dinner. So I finally had a little girl. And this is something else. I finally had a little girl, the queen of my life. I finally had her, so he was excited about it. He knew that that wasn't his baby. We had not had sex, so he knew that that wasn't his baby. So he was just there for me, and he was like, that's my baby. I don't care what nobody say, that is my baby. So I was like, cool, you know. So, you know, he was there with me the whole time, like right there. You know, he had the steak dinner with me with the wine and everything. And so then once I had the baby and I came out, my husband from nowhere popped up at my house. He said somebody had told him that I had the baby, and he came to see the baby. So once he saw the little beautiful girl that I had, he was like, oh, that's my baby. That's my baby. I want you to come back and stay with me. I want you to come back and stay with me. So, you know, all that time, it was like, what, 9 months? Yeah, it was like 8 months that I had not seen him. 8 months that he took me at my sister's house and left me. And, you know, it was just like crazy. You know, so he was like, I want you to come back and live with me and bring the baby. And I was like, I talked to my mama about it. And she was like, he's asking you to come back now because... just because you had the baby, but he should have wanted you without the baby. He didn't try to do anything for you before you had the baby. You know, so I was listening to my mom. I heard what she said. You know, so I was like, yeah, that's true. Because at first I was thinking, I'm going to go ahead. I got a baby now. He want me to come back to him. I'm going to go ahead and go back to him. But no, I changed my mind. I just said, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to stay in this friendship relationship that I had with this other guy. So then eventually, after he asked me to come back and I said no, I think in about 2 weeks later, you know, he drove up and came and wanted to see the baby, and he had another lady in the car with him. So he was telling me that he had been dating her for a while. So was this the time that you dropped me off and say you needed time to yourself, that you got with this lady? How long you been knowing this lady? Now she's driving up with you. We still married. She's in the car with you. Everywhere you go, I see her with you. So what is going on with this? So then he told me that he wanted to get married to this lady, and that he was gonna divorce me and get married to this lady. So I was like, oh my goodness, you got to be kidding. I was thinking to myself, oh my goodness, I've already messed up my life. That's what I was thinking. I got married. Now here I am getting ready to get a divorce. This man wanna get a divorce from me. Oh my goodness, I done messed up my life. That's what I was thinking to myself. So during that time, my whole life felt shattered. I still was in a depression state. So anyway, that's it for this part, you guys. So I can't have this video too much longer. So I will come back with the rest of the part of my life and what has taken place with your girl, the Boxer JA, from that time up into this time. So I have a lot of blogging to do. I have a lot of story time to do, because I want someone from out of my story. I want someone to get some strength to know that you're not alone and that you can go forward. 58 years old I am now, and I have went forward. I'm not gonna tell you I haven't dotted every I and crossed every T. I have not. But you can move on with your life, and you can go on. So anyway, you guys, if you like more videos like this, let your girl know, the Foxy J47. And believe it or not, I have plenty more story times to tell you, and not just about my marriage, but plenty more. So anyway, you guys, that being said, I will talk to you guys on my next video. Peace and love, and move out of the way. Old school is coming through. I'll talk to you guys later. Peace. Much love. Mwah.